Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This lecture is entitled The OR Logic Function. Okay, so we've had a brief introduction to the OR logic function. Let's go into it in a little bit more detail. Obviously, we remember our truth table for our OR logic, and we can have a description of the OR logic, which is the output is high when any input is high. So let's just redo that truth table right over here. We have two inputs for this particular gate, 0, 0, 0, 1. 1011. When any input is high, neither of them are high. B is high. A is high. A and B are high. Okay, so that is our output for the OR gate. Okay, schematically, what does the OR gate look like? It's kind of the scooping back point to it, and it has its inputs there and its output here. Additionally, we'd have a rectangular symbol with a greater than or equal 1 with our inputs. It could be any number of inputs. And our single out. Let's go ahead and apply this truth table to a timing diagram, very similar to what we did with our AND gates. Here's our input A, here's our input B. Input A takes these values, input B takes this value. What does our output X look like? Just use your truth table, walk from left to right in the timing diagram. Where are we currently? A is a 0, B is a 0, right there. Obviously, our output X should be a 0. Now where are we? We are right here in the timing diagram. A is a 0, B is a 1 on the truth table. 0 or 1 is equivalent to a 1. Continue. A is 1 ORed with B 0 right there. Should be a 1. Finally, A is 1 ORed with B 1 right there on the truth table. So the timing diagram, all we did was just take our truth table and put it into the timing diagram. And just like the AND gate and the NOT gate, as long as that device is functional, it's going to OR the two inputs. In text or in written examples, you will see the expression A OR B. X equals A OR B. I know that looks like a plus, but it really is. It's called logical addition, which is slightly different than the addition that you've been dealing with. Because 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. Logical addition, 1 plus 1 is 1. There's no carry out. I previously mentioned about carry outs and sums. I have an erroneous answer in that particular lecture. The binary addition, 1 plus 1 should equal carry out 1, sum 0. Okay, obviously 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. And that is, in binary, that is 2. We'll go into that. Don't worry about it so much right now. But we're dealing with logical addition or Boolean addition. It's an OR gate. It looks like an OR gate. It's plus. So don't say plus too in class. It's OR. In our particular class, it's OR. Go to your math class. Yeah, you can call it a plus. Okay, how is that expression written in VHDL? Let's say our output signal is X. We are assigning output signal A OR B, semicolon. OR is a reserved keyword that cannot be used for anything else but the OR operator. So that was a pretty simple addition there. Let's go ahead and do another timing diagram, a little bit more complicated inputs, and let's see if you can figure it out. I'll go ahead and clean this up. Okay, so here's a signal, A being fed to one input of an OR gate, B being fed to the input of another. What is the output? X on the timing diagram. Go ahead and pause this recording. Go ahead and see if you can do the analysis, which I'm about to do. Okay, hopefully you're back. Hopefully you're going to come up with something very similar to what we did. Again, notice I've taken away the truth table for you. It's up to you to know how these things work. And again, you don't necessarily need the whole truth table. What you need is that description. An OR gate takes a high value when any of its inputs are high. So what I'm going to do is just kind of walk along. A is high, A is high, B is high, A is high, B is high, and look at this. Got a region here where A is high and B is high. So any input is high. Well, they're both high, so might as well just keep that going, ORing them together. B is high, finally back to A high. So you can kind of see what's going on here with regard to addition. It is kind of like it's adding together signal A and B. Just so happens to you at that moment, which I've highlighted, A and B are both high. When you add them together, when you kind of put signals together, obviously they're both going to have a high value if there are only two possible states. So that is a time diagram example of an OR gate. Let's go ahead and put another one in there. Let's see if you can do this. Okay, so waveform A is taking some digital data coming in. It's got inputs up and down. Looks like B is constantly high. So I could draw this as plus 5 volts. What does the output X look like when A, which is an incoming digital data stream, is ORed with a constant logic 1. Go ahead and pause. Go ahead and figure that out. And hopefully you're back and you'll realize that anytime A ORed with 1 is always 1. Because anytime any input is high, the output is high. So your output should look something like that. We'll come back to this one in a little bit. Go ahead and do the opposite land. What happens if I've taken B and hooked it to ground? That's what the B input looks like. What's my output now? Anytime any input is high, my output is high. What do I get here? Basically the same output that I had coming in on A. Does that make sense? What does that look like expression-wise? A or a zero is always A. That makes sense. You're adding a zero. You're logically adding a zero to an incoming digital data stream. This is a great example of some of the Boolean laws that we'll be dealing with. Very similar to what I did on the AND gates. I'm going to give you guys two challenges here. Okay, so here are our two challenge circuits. In the top one, X1, both inputs are receiving A. So X1's expression should look like A or A. A happens to have a digital data stream that looks like this. Now what about X2? X2 has A coming into this input. Tricky, tricky. It has not A coming into that other input. So what is X2? It is A or not A. Okay, so we'll hit these things again. We'll get Boolean laws. Just if you understand what you're talking about right now, you should be able to figure these things out. While I've got these things here, let's just do an example for VHDL coding. How would I write this? I know this might hit you pretty hard right now. X2 is assigned the value of A or not A. You can use parentheses if you wish. You do have to use a semicolon. We'll go into that a little bit. But these are two challenging problems. We'll go ahead and hit those things in Boolean laws. Okay, so how is the OR logic function applied? You should be familiar with this diagram for motor controls. And like I said in a previous lecture, essential. This is what the digital electronics is doing. It's preparing you to understand the logical control of systems via motor control or PLCs. Whereas an AND was a series relationship of switches, an OR is a parallel relationship of switches. If we look at our motor control diagram up there, if switch A closes, that coil is energized. If switch B closes, that coil is energized. If neither of them close, it is not energized. If both of them close, it is energized. So it's neat. It's an OR operation can be used as perhaps controlling a piece of equipment from two locations, the A side of the wall or the B side of the wall, or both together. So it's a parallel operation, OR. What are other applications of the OR function? Okay, we previously referred to as masks in the AND as far as a computer function. There's also masks where I want to insert a bit. As opposed to clear everything out, I want to go ahead and insert a bit. And the example of this is ASCII. Pretty much every key on your keyboard has an ASCII code assigned to it. It's a 7-bit code. Actually, it's 8 bits, but the MSB, the one all the way to the left, is always a zero. But there's 7 bits that are assigned a code, a binary code, when you press that key. And the example is the A key. And that's my A0, 2, A3, A4, A5, A6. And there really is but it's always a zero. I'll just put that to the side. That is the code for capital A. Whereas the code for little a, exact same thing, with the exception of that one bit right there, okay, the A5 bit. So what a masking does, whereas previously we had seen in those timing diagrams, we saw that AR1 is always a 1, AR0 is always an A, we can use this to our advantage. So that's what the capital caps lock or the shift command is doing there. It's either inserting or removing that 1. So for example, I've got capital A and I want to make little a out of it. All I do is I feed the following mask into an OR gate, into a bunch of OR gates. Okay, so here's my cleaned up version of the schematic. What I'm going to go ahead and do is put in the representation for capital A, and that MSB, it's always a zero. Now I want to go ahead and convert it to a lowercase a. So what I'm going to do is mask it 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. So what I'm doing is I'm oring these all together. 1 or 0 is a 1, 0 or a 0 is a 0, 0 or a 0, 0. So I'm not affecting these lower bits, 0 or 0, 0. This is the one I want to affect. So I've ored it with a 1. What do I get is 1. 1 or 0 is 1. 0 or 0 is 0. Right there. It's the 7-bit ASCII representation for little a. So the OR gate can be used in switching arrangements to provide parallel operation, operation from a different area. It can also be used in a computer to insert a particular bit in a particular position. Okay, this kind of concludes this portion of the lecture. One brief thing before we close here, what I've got is the pinout diagram for the 7432. This is the TTL logic gate for an OR, which we'll be using, in lab. Notice again, VCC and ground. It is a quad 2 input OR gate, 7432. The inputs for gate 3 are 9 and 10, and its output is pin 8. Where would the notch go? The notch would be there. That is, again, do not remember these numbers. We're going to give them to you. Don't feel like you need to remember the ASCII code for capital A or little a. Don't do that. You got way more important things to remember besides all that stuff. Let's go into, our last lecture in this particular series, electronics test equipment as applied to digital electronics.